Instead of setting all the parameters for the newly created elements every time, you can also save and reuse parameters by defining favorites. Similar to attributes, you can export and import the favorite settings between projects later on. You can apply the favorite settings to existing elements, as well as using them as a basis for new elements. You can access the favorites using the favorites palette. Make sure that all elements are deselected. Choose Window, Palettes, Favorites. By default, you can see some predefined favorites available. If a tool is activated, the list will show the relevant favorites only. Let's assume that we want to use a favorite we created in a former project already. Next to the additional settings, click the arrow icon to display the available options. Click the Import/Export item. Click Import from File, ARCHICAD Project or PRF. Search and select the existing favorites preference file. Click Open. In the upcoming dialog, click Import to append the additional favorites to the current project. Notice that the exterior wall slanted will appear in the favorites list. Close the favorites palette for now. Now we will create some additional walls. Open the ground floor from the project map of the pop-up navigator or simply from the tab bar. Open the wall settings dialog. Display the geometry and positioning panel. Click on the favorites button at the top. Select exterior wall slanted from the list. Click Apply. Note that the parameter settings changed in the settings dialog. This is a solid stone wall with one side slanted. Make sure that the basic structure is selected and then set the building material to stone, structural. Display the floor plan and section panel. Select the entire element option for the show projection entry in the floor plan display list. Make sure that the structural bearing layer is selected. Click OK to apply all changes. Select the straight geometry method in the info box. Set the reference line to the outside face. First, we create a straight segment 2 meters from the existing wall, then we'll modify it. To find the precise locations, we will use guidelines. First, make sure that the Guidelines button is switched on at the standard toolbar. Move your cursor to the top middle of the screen over the orange dotted line. Drag the guideline by holding down the left mouse button and moving to the long edge of the wall. Hover the cursor over the appearing orange spot. Click on it and drag the line up by holding down the left mouse button. Type 2 in the tracker. Press Enter. If not visible, the tracker can be activated from the standard toolbar by pressing the Show Hide Tracker button. Draw the wall between the intersection points of the guideline and the traced dash lines, starting from the left side. Select the slanted wall. Click on the right side endpoint. Select the stretch command in the pet palette. Move the endpoint of the wall downwards. Hold down the shift key while moving the cursor downwards. Do not release the shift button. And type D1 to define the endpoint 1 meter below its original position. Press Enter. Now, click on the reference line of the slanted wall and select the curve edge icon on the pet palette. Move the cursor upwards and type 30 in the tracker as radius. Press Enter. To pick up the parameters of elements and set them as default, activate the eyedropper button in the standard toolbar. The cursor will change to an eyedropper. You can also press the Alt key shortcut to activate the eyedropper. Now, pick up the settings of the existing external wall. Move the eyedropper above the external wall so that it will be highlighted, and the tracker will provide you with some brief details about the wall. Click on the wall. Note that the wall tool will be activated in the toolbox, and the info box will also refer to the wall. Open the wall settings dialog and display the geometry and positioning panel. Set the wall top to the first story. Enter 0.00 for the top offset to top linked story value. Click OK. Make sure that the single geometry method is selected in the info box, and that the position of the wall reference line is set to core inside. Draw the front and the back walls of the entrance enclosure with the help of guidelines created 1.8 meters from the outside edge of the wall. Draw the wall downwards on the left side. And upwards on the right side. You can see that some skins of the multi-layer wall intersect the stone wall, and some layers of the external wall do not intersect correctly. This is because the skin priorities are not set correctly. The bigger the priority number, the stronger the wall or wall skin will be when it comes to intersection with other walls. You can set the priority between 0 and 999. You can set skin priorities by building materials. Select the brick wall and open Options, Element Attributes, Building Materials. The materials that the selected composite wall uses are highlighted in the list. Select the masonry block structural skin and check its priority. It's 730, which means that the stone wall must have an equal or higher priority number to avoid unneeded intersections. Select the stone structural wall in the list. Set its priority up to at least 730. Click OK. Now the walls appear correctly on the floor plan.